in Greek schools, and especially in our school, we've been practicing debating for many, many, many years. There's a special club for debating in English. These students, okay, do not belong to this club. They know the rules, they know the rules. They have been doing this in classrooms with another in their Greek classrooms. But it is their first time that they are debating in English under these rules. Okay? So, normally what we do in English, in English debating, we give the students a motion. Motion is the topic. We give the students a motion, they prepare it for 15 minutes, okay, on two sides, the government and the opposition. They prepare their arguments, and then the debate begins. There is a judge that says which of the two teams finally won, the government or the opposition. The government is here to present the measure, to explain why they want to, as a government, they want to do this thing, to implement this. And the opposition is here to explain why we should not do such a thing. Now, we chose a topic that matched your previous week's winning project, as we saw, and this was the part of it that was sexist advertising. And it is also related to women issues. And they are not going to have the 15 minutes preparation now because they have already worked a bit on the topic. So we can immediately proceed. We can begin. Is there anyone who wants to ask something? Something that I need to repeat, something you don't understand, something that sounds strange or... Okay? Or after that, if you want to ask something, okay, I can,
okay. So, I'd like to welcome you to this debate today. Our motion is this house would ban sexist advertising. And I would like to ask the Prime Minister to stand up and explain and define the motion for us today.
Good morning, honorable judges, worthy opponents, and ladies and gentlemen of this house. Today's motion is this house would ban sexist advertising. I think we have all seen an advertisement with a man testing a super fast car or a woman ironing some clothes with a brand new iron of a global company. Well, we're here today to support that this kind of advertising should not be allowed, mainly because they support the gender stereotypes that exist in our society. Before I proceed with our first argument, let me define the motion. Banning refers to the public restriction of a particular action to achieve a desired goal. Sexist advertising, then, is a promotion of goods or services which stereotype men or women based on gender. Okay, let me proceed with my first argument. Ladies and gentlemen, we all know that the one generation passes their knowledge to the next one. This is what is going to happen with the forms and standards that have been created over the years correlating in gender inequality, if we don't change those beliefs in our people's worldview. So, this is why we think banning sexist advertising is the right move to make in our current situation. For the above mentioned, we urge you to propose. Thank you.
Honourable Judge, worthy opponents, ladies and gentlemen of this House. As the opposition leader, I'm here to oppose to what the government has said. We heard from the government that the generations pass their knowledge to the next one. The government said that by banning sexist advertisement, sexism would be prevented. This is clearly not going to happen. It's impossible. If it was that easy, it would have happened years ago. People should focus on education and change beliefs, and not hope to change everything just by banning sexist advertisements. And now for the argument. First, ads that show a specific gender are not necessarily sexism. They're just targeted to a specific consumers group, and businesses need to to the target group to relate in order to make profit. Because as we all know, this is the main goal of most businesses. For example, how can you make an ad on makeup without using women and hope for women to buy to actually buy this product? Second of all, businesses should take matters in their own hands. Government shouldn't have a say in this because it's purely a matter of businesses. Thank you for your attention.
Honorable Judge, Board of Governors, ladies and gentlemen of this House. Firstly, we would like to rebut the arguments of the opposition. You claim that any changes in advertising should come from business themselves rather than through banning. But even though some businesses have responded to public opinion, there are sufficient international commitments which address gender inequality in all societies. Also, waiting upon the private sector to respond would take too long and would be very insufficient. Finally, you claim that advertisements are the main source of income, but making profit by promoting sexism is completely unethical and inhuman. Now, we'd like to move to our arguments. Advertisements are harmful to society, and especially women, because women get harmed through objectification, and their self-image gets diminished. Also, through these verbal and visual messages, women are portrayed as subservient to men, and this image does not respect human rights, but it also promotes inequality. Secondly, an ideal body is shown, and because people being prone to advertisements, women feel pressed and may feel that they are not good enough, and that will have a negative effect in their society, as there will be anxiety and maybe depression. Finally, we do have some examples of countries which have banned sexist advertising, as Norway and Denmark. And this was very beneficial for their society as it promoted the social and psychological balance of it. So why don't we follow that example? Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen of this House, as a second member of the opposition, after having carefully considered everyone's opinion, I'd like to rebut my opponent's argument and support the idea that sexist advertising shouldn't be banned. At first, I have to say that my opponent stated that this is sexist advertising promotes sexist ideas and it has sexist meaning. But The advert meaning is like to make profit for companies, isn't it right? They are just representing reality in order so they can appeal to the public. I believe it, and as Miltos stated, the leader of the opposition, it's better to invest on education and not to limitize companies. Companies, by paying taxes, help the economy, and this also helps like organize.
Ladies and gentlemen of this House, the debate has come down to two major classes. On the one side, we have team opposition claiming that sexist advertising is subjective. However, due to this type of advertisement, the status of women have been undermined, which harm them, but It also harms society in general. The position also supports that consumers have a choice and right to respond to ads and their meaning. Therefore, Therefore, since the nature of advertising is planned for public consumption, then ads contribute to the existence of these, let's say, attitudes inside the person. They also claim that ads are the main source of income of businesses, which is which true actually, but it's a
ladies and gentlemen, as my proposition counterpart already mentioned, the two sides of this debate have entirely different and opposite attitudes towards the issue. On the one hand, the proposition, after defining the word banning as forbidding any gender inequality-based ads and sexist as discrimination of gender, went on to claim that sexist advertising hurts society and that each generation grows up with the prejudices of the previous generations, to which we oppose with the question of why shouldn't the older generations teach the younger ones how to react to ads and how to know the difference between sexist ads and just plain ads. Furthermore, they said that today's society is full of stereotypes and that